Welcome back to the channel, everybody. In this video, we'll be looking at a pair of simultaneous equations. This is that pair of simultaneous equations, and we're going to solve that pair of simultaneous equations by substitution. Let's get right into it.
So we're going to use the method of substitution today. And substitution means we're going to take one whole equation and put it into another equation. So let's get this all labeled up. I'll call this equation 1 and call this equation 2. And I'm going to say from equation 1, what I'm going to do, and you can pick any equation, by the way, I'm just choosing equation 1. So from equation 1, I'm going to make y the subject. So let's rewrite equation 1 quickly. So that becomes 2x plus y is equal to 8. Now, in order to make y the subject, I need to get rid of this 2x here. It's in my way. Y being the subject means that y is on its own on one side of the equal sign. So this 2x needs to go. So right now, this 2x is being added to y. So all I got to do is subtract it from y to get rid of it. So take it away. But don't forget, you have to do both sides. You can't just do it on one side. That means that 2x take away 2x is cancelled out. Y is now on its own. And then I've got 8 take away 2x on this side. And I will call this one equation 3. Now that I've rearranged equation 1 and turned it into equation 3, I can now substitute equation 3 into equation 2, because I haven't touched equation 2 as yet. So let's jot that down. So we're going to substitute equation 3 into equation 2. So what do I mean by that? Now, you notice here this says y is equal to 8 minus 2x. Then it means that in equation 2, where there is a y, let's highlight it. So where there is y, I can replace that y for 8 minus 2x because I know that y is equal to 8 minus 2x. So just replace that. So once we replace that, it means that now we've got minus 3x plus 8 minus 2x is equal to minus 2. Okay, so now we start solving this here now. And we have now got minus 3x take away 2x. That's going to give us minus 5x. What we can do while we're at it, we can take away this 8 from both sides. Just get rid of it now, I think, which means it's going to cancel out here. And that's going to be minus 10 over there. Because negative 2 take away 8 minus 10. And then now we obviously divide by negative 5 on both sides to get rid of the negative 5. Don't forget, we're trying to find x. That cancels out. X will now equal to 2. You might think at this point that you're finished, but you're not. Because now you need to go and find y. After all, it's a pair of simultaneous equations and you need two answers. You need one for variable x and one for variable y. So we're going to substitute x is equal to 2 in, well, you've got loads to choose from. You've got this equation, that equation, and this equation. I'm going to choose equation 3, mainly because y is already the subject, so life is easy with that. So I'm going to substitute it in y equal to 8 minus 2x. I should point out here, it does not matter which equation you substitute it in, you're going to get the same answer. Okay, so here we go. So now that, what does that mean? It means that I'm going to take this 2 and replace this x over here with that 2. So y will equal to 8 take away 2 times 2. So 8 take away 4, which is 4. And then there we have our solution. X is equal to 2 and y is equal to 4. Absolutely amazing. Now, before I finish up the video here, I want to just check one more thing with you. How do you know that your answer is correct? So I've got x is 2 and y is 4. How can we check that it's definitely correct? Well, take your two answers and plug it into any of these equations you've got here and see what happens. So I'm going to choose this first equation here. So I'm going to change color because this is just a test. So we're just going to test that x is indeed 2 and y is indeed 4. And we're going to substitute it into 2x plus y is equal to 8. That means I'm going to replace this x for 2 and I'm going to replace this y for 4. And once I'm finished working, my answer should be 8. So that means I've now got 2 times 2 plus 4. 2 times 2 is 4. Add 4, which is 8, which is the same answer we have there. And that's how I know for sure my answer is correct.
The YouTube algorithm thinks that you're going to want to see this video next, so make sure you hit that window. Once you finish that, make sure you hit that button down there to subscribe to the channel. Don't forget to hit the notification bell though, so that you know every time I put another video live.